Around 75% of Americans live about 5 miles from a Dollar General store, so chances are you already shopped at, or at least drove past, one this month. In fact, there are more than 17,000 stores in 46 states across the U.S. The retailer already aims to offer convenience and the everyday low prices on products that Americans desire. Now, in addition to being a cheap and quick shopping spot, Dollar General hopes to establish itself as a health destination. What does this mean, exactly? Among other things, the chain plans to add more cough and cold, dental, nutritional, medical, health aids, and feminine hygiene products to store shelves. In doing so, Dollar General aims to expand access to healthcare products and services at affordable prices. With our extensive store footprint, often in communities others have chosen not to serve, Dollar General is uniquely positioned to help combat hunger by offering convenient access to a variety of nutritious foods at affordable prices, CEO Todd Vasos said at the time. The candy aisle at the grocery store checkout was a treasure trove just waiting to be explored. One candy concoction that kids begged for was a Wonder Ball. The packaging had a theme, whether it was princesses, animals, or superheroes. Once inside the box, a chocolate ball was wrapped in foil, and inside that chocolate ball were hard, chalky candies shaped like the theme of the Wonder Ball. There was also some sort of prize, like a sticker or temporary tattoo that your parents usually ended up throwing away. Melody Pops were the bane of parents, teachers, and pretty much anyone who had to be around kids. These weird lollipops looked kind of like a recorder but had a stick inside that was able to move up and down to create a different tone instead of using your fingers to cover holes. The sounds that came out of the so-called Melody Pops were anything but delightful. They were usually high-pitched squeals and ear-piercing scratches that 90s kids usually thought sounded great but never did. The pops lost most kids' interest after the sugar began to disintegrate where you blew in to make the noise or the stick popped out of the pop completely. These strange chewy Jell-O snacks were never a hit but somehow still have groups of people wanting them back on shelves in the grocery store. The Jell-O gummies came in three flavors, chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry. The pudding bites had almost no flavor and were so chewy that it was a challenge to even get through one, let alone finish a whole package. These are one snack we're glad stayed in the 90s with no hope of coming back. Kids who loved tater tots loved potato smileys even more. The strange little discs of potato were baked in the oven and placed on lunch and dinner plates across the country. The best part about these was that there were cut-out eyes and a smile right in the disc. Kids would try to take the ketchup from each other to draw out more unique features like eyebrows, a nose, or a mustache on these before devouring. Even though these are long gone, we not so secretly wish they would make a comeback. Dinosaurs have always been cool, but after the debut of chicken fries were one of the more interesting selections from the freezer aisle, and the Burger King menu, back in the day. The thin strips of chicken were coated, fried, and frozen to look just like French fries. Then when you got them home they were baked in the oven to reheat them before dunking into ketchup and eating. The shape might have fooled some kids into eating them. But after that first bite, everything usually went downhill. These are still on sale at some stores, but they should have stayed in the past. There was nothing like coming home on a cold day after playing outside with the other neighborhood kids to find out that your mom had heated up a can of alphabet soup for you. The tomato-based soup was filled with all 26 letters from the alphabet. The best part about this soup wasn't the taste, but spelling out words, names, or places. Alphabet soup gave a whole new meaning to the term playing with your food. And usually, because you were spelling, your mom didn't yell at you for not eating your lunch. If the name, Shark Bites, didn't freak you out as a kid, getting a whole pack of white gummy sharks sure did. These gummy snacks that made their way into a lot of school lunches were all shaped like different types of sharks, which automatically made him cool. Outside of the shape, the flavor of each shark wasn't great. And these were usually passed over for a better gummy snack like Gushers if you could persuade a parent to buy them at the grocery store. As if a jug of gum wasn't weird enough, putting the sticks of gum in a tin can that looked like a Band-Aid box was even weirder. The wrappers on each of the sticks of gum even looked like Band-Aids. This gum wasn't going to heal any scrapes you got out on the playground, though. The gum came in three flavors, watermelon, grape, and strawberry, but the flavor only lasted for a few minutes before it was completely gone. This gum is still sold in specialty candy stores, but the tin can is no longer in production, so it's not the nostalgic gum we remember from our childhood. These look so cool on the outside of the box, with Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Donald Duck, and Goofy all having a popsicle made in their likeness. Once the pops were out of the box, though, they never looked like the Disney pals we all know. Each of the popsicles had a different flavor, and fighting over the best one, hello, orange, with your friends was always the worst part of eating these. Call the Ghostbusters, because Hi-C Ecto Cooler juice boxes need to make a comeback from our childhood food dreams. The juice drink was made to help promote this was a rope-like fruit gummy that was twirled around like a fruit roll-up onto a plastic tray. These usually made it into lunchboxes but were never that great in the end. The gummy rope was hard to get through if you wanted to eat it a bite at a time. Even eating the whole thing at once was hard because of how chewy the snack was. Fruit strings came in all sorts of flavors imaginable, but we still tried to trade them away at lunch.